TV News at 10. Despite the mudslinging between groups of lawmakers and the House of Representatives over the alleged padding of the 2016 budget, Nigerians may have little to worry about. Well, that's because the federal government has given the assurance that the budget eventually signed by the president was better than the one first returned to the presidency by the National Assembly. Speaking at a town hall meeting in Abuja, the Minister of Budget and National Planning, Senator Udoma, explained that the executive was not satisfied with the initial work done on the budget by the legislature. Our correspondent Amaka Okafo reports.
SMS platform.
It's a gathering of Nigerians from different walks of life, including the Sultan of Sokoto, who is an alumni of the National Institute for Policy and Strategic Studies. The event is a town hall meeting on the implementation of the 2016 budget and good governance policy of the Buhari administration. In attendance at the town hall meeting are the ministers of budget and planning, solid minerals, finance, foreign affairs and information. Others are the Minister of Agriculture, Power, Works and Housing and the Minister of Environment. To set the ball rolling, the Sultan of Sokoto tasked government to ensure that the 2016 budget is not just a budget on paper, but one that will be effectively implemented. Next, the Minister of Budget and National Planning had this to say when asked if there are items that reflect the allegation of padding in the 2016 budget.
When they finish with that process, they now send it back to the executive. If we are satisfied with it, the president signs. If we are not, we ask them to look at it again. In this case, we were not satisfied. And for the reasons which we had given at the time. And we ask them to look at the documents again. And when they finished, they now sent it back. It was a better document, and we felt, and the president felt able to sign.
Still on the economy, the Minister of Finance assured Nigerians that the country will overcome the recession. She, however, defends the borrowing policy of the current administration, while the Minister of Power, Housing and Works is hopeful that the budget will make the desired impacts on Nigerians.
I really don't see that there's any option than to borrow. But we will borrow sustainably, we will borrow conservatively to make sure that we don't burden future generations. But if we borrow and invest, you see, the difference is we've been borrowing in the past to pay salaries. Now we're borrowing to invest. When you borrow to invest, there's an expectation that there will be additional revenues that will service those borrowings.
We must just stay focused. It's a tough time. We are mindful, but we think that our methods will work. And the purpose of our presence here, if I may say so on behalf of our colleagues, is also to see whether there are things that we are missing and to listen to them, take them back in and look at what we can do to improve them.
As Nigerians leave this town hall meeting, it is hoped that the government will match its words with action to ensure a better life for all Nigerians. Amaka Okafor, Channels Television News.
But the stance of the Minister of Budget and National Planning on the 2016 budget appears different from the position of the former chairman of the House Committee on Appropriation, Honorable Abdul Mumin Dibrin. In an interview with Channels Television, the lawmaker said the final copy of the budget, as passed and signed by President Muhammadu Buhari, was padded.
Were there senseless insertions in the 2016 budget?
Absolutely, there were a lot of insertions that I took objection to.
And it was passed?
It was passed.
In the document that was passed?
In the document that we passed.
How bad was were these insertions? Well, a lot of Nigerians will call it pardon. How bad was the pardon?
Well, I have explained this a lot, that we did statistics after collecting the reports from the various committees. Of course, we run the figures. And shockingly, I discovered that in between about 10 standing committees of the House, mind you, the House has about 96 standing committees, just about 10 standing committees, posted about 2,000 projects. 2,000 projects totaling about 284 billion naira. And I was a bit worried. For 5 years, I've been working on budget. As chairman of finance, I was also part of the budgeting process. I've never seen that kind of situation. And even in the past, The few reports I read, a few chairmen of appropriation budgeting process from 1999 to date, have never seen that numbers of insertion into the budget.
Away from issues to do with the budget, the name Mr. Akintola Williams is one that's synonymous with accountancy, particularly because he's the first African chartered accountant and the founder of the renowned Akintola Williams Deloitte. To this end, a foundation has been set up in his honor. The event, which held in Lagos, was made extra special with the cutting of a cake in celebration of his 97th birthday. Our correspondent Oreoluwa Shunibare reports.
Mr. Akintola Williams is a name that means many things to many people. He has been described as a doyen of the accountancy profession by virtue of his achievements in the industry. Today, however, is not just about his exploits in accountancy. It's about celebrating a man that has touched humanity across board, especially as he attains an enviable 97 years of age. Among those gathered here are members of his family, friends, and some of those who have passed through his tutelage. They have come up with their own way of stamping his name and virtues in the minds of generations to come, a foundation.
I too believe that honor is best appreciated and so should be given to whom it is due whilst that person is still alive. It has therefore instituted this foundation as a mark of honor and recognition of the contributions of Mr. Akintola Williams to the development and growth of the accountancy profession in this country and indeed all Africa.
Great men should be celebrated during their lifetime. They should also live long enough to see their names written in gold. And the history of ICANN cannot be complete without mentioning the name of this great man who played a very significant role in the formation of ICANN some 51 years ago.
In Lagos State, I would not see roads or buildings or anything standing by to recognize Mr. Akintola Williams. It should be done.
Obviously touched by the affection of all, the celebrant expresses his gratitude with a few words.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I thank you from the very bottom of my heart, and I know that all of us are now anxious to have something in our tongue.
The Akintola Williams Foundation is set up to inculcate the spirit of humanitarianism and patriotism, among others, virtues that are synonymous with the man in whose honor this has been put together. Channels Television News.
Mr. Akintola Williams at 97, a worthy honor indeed. We cross over to our business studios now, and here's Melinda Akinlami.
You first. First Bank.
Welcome to Business News. Nigeria's Central Bank has issued a directive allowing all commercial banks clean up their books by writing off bad loans in 2016 only. The Apex Bank blames the decision on loans to different sectors, falling naira value, and the shrinking economy, which has put pressure on banks' non-performing loans well above the acceptable 5% risk average. The financial regulator expects the relief being granted to improve banks' liquidity, firm up viability ratings, and boost their operations. The interbank foreign exchange market is also getting some support from the CBN after the naira hits an all-time low of 350 to the dollar. Dealers say a single transaction of $100,000 was carried out at 350 per dollar, while a total of $6.86 billion were traded. The naira rose by 1% to close at 312.50 against the greenback following the regulator's intervention. The federal government wants to appoint two international banks as joint lead managers and a financial advisor to organize the issuance of $1 euro bonds. According to the Debt Management Office, the sale is the first tranche of the federal government's $4.5 billion global medium-term issuance program that will run till 2018. The Eurobond sales this year will be the first since the federal government tapped into the market in 2013. In the meantime, the federal government has borrowed 600 billion naira in the first half of this year to make up for the shortfall in revenue generation. According to the Ministry of Budget and National Planning, the amount is borrowed from the domestic market as contained in the proposed medium-term expenditure framework from 2017 to 2019. The 600 billion naira borrowed in the first 6 months of 2016 is about 33% of the 1.8 trillion naira approved for borrowing in the 2016 budget. Trading sentiments remain weak for the second time this week as negative market breadth and broad sector losses suggest investors are not sure about domestic versus outlook. Let's join Bolaji Akinwale for those details.
Hello and welcome to the Stock Market Report. Further declines trailed Nigeria's equities markets at the close of Tuesday's trading session on concerns over the state of the country's economy. The All Share Index went down by 0.45%, while the market's capitalization dropped by 5 billion naira. The negative sentiment reflected on the price table as 30 stocks led by Sterling Bank, MRS and Nobel recorded price devaluations, while only six equities led by WAPIC, Total and Skybank gained. A total of 416 million shares worth 2.16 billion naira was churned out in 3,443 transactions. WAPIC was again the most actively traded stock with more than 153.85 million shares and was followed by FBN Holdings and UBA. And that's it on the Stock Market Reports. I am Bolaji Akinwale.
Many thanks, Bolaji. Several European earnings beat expectations, so the numbers for major markets are looking up today. Falling oil prices help push U.S. figures near record highs. And that's business news. Thank you so much for watching. Back to you, Ijoma.
You first. First Bank.
Next on the news at 10, Nigerian Football Federation appoints German coach Guillermo Roy as Super Eagles' technical advisor on a 2-year deal. That will be on sports. Do join us again.